Hello and welcome to another uMake tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to walk you through the steps necessary to create a home from shipping containers. So to get started, I'm going to create a new file in uMake. And basically, from here, I'm going to start bringing in some models of shipping containers. So where am I going to get these? Well, in the latest version of uMake, you can actually bring in files from the SketchUp warehouse, which is really cool. So I'm going to come over here to the SketchUp warehouse in Safari, and then I can search for pretty much anything that I want. And in this case, I'm going to search for a shipping container. See, shipping container, there it is. And then you have a whole selection of shipping containers you can choose from. I would prefer one that looks relatively lightweight or simple to work with. I've already kind of gone through these, and there's a particular one that I like. It's the Shipping Container 40 by Paul L. I actually like working with this one. I've tried out a couple others, but if you're looking for a good 40-foot shipping container, this model actually works very well. So I'm going to open it up, tap the download button, tap SketchUp 2018 model, and you'll get to this screen where you'll see uMake will want to open it, and you just tap open in uMake. And then it'll open uMake up and the container will load in the background. So now the container is imported into uMake. If I go out of the file we created, the container is right here. I'll open it up. You can see that it moves around. Now we could just start from this file if we wanted to, but I'm going to leave this alone simply because if I want to use this container in other files in the future, I can just have the container ready in the My Files part of the playground. So I'm going to go back out of this, go to my new file here. And then if I want to bring that container in, I'll just go over to the side panel here, go into the playground area, tap My Files, and here is the container. I already have one open. I'm going to tap this once and you'll see that it loads in. The screen kind of goes gray and there is the container. All right. So to make this easy to work with, the next thing I'm going to do is add some dimensions and get this in kind of a good dimensional space for us to work in. So I'm going to go into the settings here, going to make sure that dimensions are on, and then go to grid units. I want grid units to be in feet. And the reason for this is a 40-foot shipping container. So it's easiest to use feet when working with something that they've already given you the specified dimensions of. I'm going to double tap on this. It already was brought in as a group. And right now, the way it's loaded is it's 481 feet. So we're going to change this. So I'm going to tap on this dimension here. Make sure to tap the lock. That way the proportions will stay the same. So I'm going to tap the lock here. And then I'm just going to delete everything here and then put in 40 feet. And you'll see that gets pretty small, but that's okay. We can just zoom in because we already zoomed out quite a bit. And I will move this down like that. So now our container is 40 feet by 8 feet 6 inches high, and it should be about 8 feet wide. There we go, 8 feet 1 inches. So that works pretty well. That's about accurate. Now you'll notice that on the container there are two ends. This end has none of the handles, no doors on it, and this end does have the doors on it. Depending on how you want to create your structure, just make sure that you understand that one end is a little bit more complex than the other one, and you'll understand this as we move forward in the design work. So now we have one shipping container. Shipping container homes are kind of all the rage. I thought this would be a fun exercise to create your own shipping container home. So hopefully this tutorial will show you how to do that. Now that we have this shipping container, we can do a couple of things. The first thing I want to do is, while it's still grouped, I kind of want to lay out the containers into a nice design. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to build one out of like 8 or 9 containers. That should create a home that looks pretty cool. So I'm going to go to the front view, and right now the front view, the container is actually on its side. So I want to make sure that I rotate that. So I'm going to rotate this like that, and just to make sure Yeah, I think I'm gonna do that. If I go to the front view. Okay, so the door, the portion with the doors are in the back. Then I'm gonna just bring this down a little bit like that. Make sure that it's on the ground. If you want, you can raise them up and kind of build supports under them. For now, I'm just gonna put this on the ground. And then I'm gonna move this one over like this. And let's see. I'll move it here like that. And now I'm just gonna kind of duplicate them. So copy and then move this one over like that. And then I'll take both of these and I will bring them over. Let's see. Something like that. There we go. Bring this one up. Turn copy off because I want to move this one into the middle here. And then I'm going to rotate this one around like this and kind of make like a bridge with it. I'm going to bring this one back like that. That's starting to look pretty cool. And the next thing I'm going to do is just take each of these, copy them, and move them up like that. Turn copy off since I don't need to make any more duplicates, and I'll move these forward like that. So that is the beginning of the shipping container home. I hope this tutorial was helpful and useful. We have more of them to complete this home, but right now this is just the beginning. If you have any comments, questions, or feedback for this one, let us know. Now you know how to bring in files from the SketchUp warehouse and how to quickly manipulate them to get to a good starting point. In the next tutorial, we are going to start adding some details to this and really making it look like a home. So with that said, again, comments, questions, put them down below and stay tuned for the next tutorial. Cheers.